infinite the amount of damage that you've got, the mixed damage from Jax and the burst damage from Jinx. I also like the
touch on that mid lane for now as well. Alexic, we are actually going to see Hook, so let's forget that one. Chompers are down as well. Edward going to go low. That's a good bubble from him. Exhaust comes onto Genja as well. Wow. Darion tries to get in there, but he doesn't manage to get through onto.
Could be a potential reason for that.
Yeah, we also saw that Crystalline Flash start as we are going to see Seliver going aggressive here on towards Genja. There is the rappel. Actually had the lantern. We see the teleport coming in on towards that top side. That's Alexic down this time. They go towards Vander. There's the flash around and the first blood coming in. It's Edward that secures that one. And they, I think, forgot there that it was a second teleport on the Gambit side.
We actually see as well, over 10 minutes into it
now. Oh, Elise is in the bush.
Yeah, Elise is waiting there. We are going to see Diamond ultiing into this one. They're going to go for Zazas. Can they finish him off? He's down to half HP. Jankos, though, becomes the target of this one. There's a flash in from Diamond. It's Darion that gets the kill. Zazas able to jump away, though. That's a nice kill picked up by Gambit.
Yeah, the amount of damage returned was just...
There's no vision from Rocket. He could have come through. As there is a bubble landing on towards Vander. In comes a tidal wave as well. Have they got the damage? Summon a heal was used there by Seliver. And now they're going to try and turn this one around. Not got the...
You know, it's not over yet. Vander does almost throws up the hook. For the first time in a while, gets to defend, he can. He's been jumped up by Zazas, here comes support.
Three men coming into this one. Can they lock up Darion? I think that they can. He's got no flash. There's a super mega death rocket. It's Jankos that sinks his fangs in there to get that kill. And they've got five men here. This is a five-man push now from Rocket on that bottom tower. Three men from Gambit trying to pull
they've
his back in. They have caught Alex with the hook. The box goes down. Vander picks up that kill. The rest of the team have to back away. This is turret number three going down for Rocket.
Yeah, a small mistake here by Overpower. He was taking so many turret hits. That Diamond is making his way to this top lane. And Zazas could jump in with the Counter-Strike.
There is the stun coming down. Jankos is here as well. That's a nice move from Darion to try and get away. Wild Growth goes down as well. Darion's a dead man. Jankos picks up another kill. He's feeding on Darion right.
So either Overpower slacking or Alex is just that good. We do see Zazas and Darion. Here comes Alex as well.
Oh, Alex just waiting for this one, waiting for Zazas to go low, but he jumps on towards Darion. Darion dodges off there. Just in time to stay alive. And now Alex is going head-to-head with Zazas, who's doing a fair old chunk of damage. Will he jump over to Darion? No, he won't. Darion got the health back. That'll be a kill. The dragon, in the meantime, did go down, though, in favor of Rocket.
So safer would be a safer way to put it. Seliver, he's going to get dived.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to get away from it either. That's three men coming in, but Wild Growth comes out. Darion sank
wow.
in the turret. Zazas gets that one. Incredible stuff. Slow is flashed away from there by Diamond. Alexic will riftwalk. It's all about the hook. He has to flash it.
I cannot believe how close that was to Seliver going down. The summoner heal plus that Wild Growth keeps him alive. Now they're on Baron and they are going to shred through this. There's nobody really close by. Now Diamond's coming in. There's a teleport as well.
Teleport coming to the backside. Baron is already very low. The tidal wave going to go through the middle of the team. There is a Baron taken by Rocket. They get the kill as well. We did see Flesh goes down, but Darion's diving in there. Alexic is there as well. Darion is going to die from this one, but both Genja and Alexic doing masses of damage. There's a good rappel away, but he can't get away from the damage. Double kill for Alexic. A 4-for-2 in the end. Yes, Rocket got that Baron, but the kills were nice from Gambit.
It restores mana if he hits champions. And when you combo that with the Iceborne Gauntlet, oh, we'll get to that. Zazas may go down.
Going to get caught a little bit from this one. Did get his stun off and actually will leap strike as well. There's a ward at the backside, which Alexic is going to take away. The dragon now down to less than half HP. They're going to try and come in for this one. It's going to be Gambit that get it. There's a rappel coming away. Good tidal wave will knock them in the air, but it's Seliver that picks up Darion first. Diamond's going to fall as well. He was exhausted for that fight. And now Zazas and Seliver just start to rip through the entirety of the team. Alexic is going to try and escape. Genja will get away. Alexic is probably going to run them on a bit of a wild goose chase here, but as the slow lands onto him, that makes it all the harder. The play comes in, and it's the shutdown from Jankos. That's a 4-for-0 in favor of Rocket.
Gaggle to focus down on Jax, who's going to throw down his ultimate and get bonus resistances. So at the end of the day, Gambit stayed grouped up, and they didn't blow somebody up. They have re-engaged now. Overpower may get taken out, or not.
Or not. Darion might get taken out. He went a little bit too deep on that one. The rest of the Rocket team's coming in. Wait for the hook to come through. Where is it going to go? Vander throws it out. He catches Edward at the back. Goes straight in. Wild Growth knocks Darion up as well. And that's two more kills for Rocket with the turret as well. Diamond is trying to get away. Seliver going very, very deep on that one. Alexic tries to burst him down, but they've got tower takedown potential as the hook lands onto Alex. He riftwalks to safety again, but the in-him turret's down and Rocket are going for the in-him.
There's nothing that can stop them right now. Alex and Diamond, if they want to commit, I'm convinced they're going to get dropped down. Rocket. assassins. You have upfront burst and you want somebody to execute. I wonder why they didn't go for a Jinx as their AD carry. Yes, it would have been a bit riskier, but they would have had the damage to close out those fights. Right now, though, you do see Baron has been started. Gambit coming in from the sides. They peeled for Diamond.
Oh, Diamond, though, is going to get cocooned, and he's going to go down. That was brilliant stuff. You saw the ping ward point in position there. Gave them the vision, not invisible anymore. And the Baron is going to go for a second time in a row over to Rocket.
At this point in time, Rocket
needs to move up closer on towards that turret. They've actually pulled Alexic away from this one. They're going to go for the 5v4. Box comes down. Alexic getting caught in the cocoon. There is a tidal wave going over as well. A good bubble comes in, but look at Selivar with the wild growth on. And now Jax is in the fight. He's absolutely hammering away on them. Darien's going to fall. That's two men down. All five members of Rocket are still alive on this one. They're going to take the inhibitor. The inhibitor will fall as well. And now they're chased over on towards Siren. The hook doesn't land. Well, that's the first inhibitor. The
this
second
is game.
One will go down.
They're panicked. They're trying to focus him down. They've caught Diamond.
They've caught Diamond. The flame will knock him back into sure death. Now Genja is going to be the focus. One more hit will do it. That's another kill for Selivar. The Nexus turrets are already gone. And it's Rocket that pick up game number one here.